In this episode of the Guru Guha Mandira Parikrama, we will travel to the southernmost districts of Tamil Nadu, Tirunelveli and Ramanathapuram. We will visit some prominent temples in these districts and explore the mythologies associated with them. We will visit the shrines of the presiding deities here and listen to the krutis of Muthuswami Dikshitar in praise of these deities. The penultimate southernmost district of Tamil Nadu is the district of Tirunelveli. During Puranic times, the place was called Venuvana, a forest of bamboos. Under the rule of the Pandyan dynasty, the district was known as Ten Pandyanadu. The Chola dynasty then named it Mudikonda Chola Mandalam. The Madurai Nayaks called it Tirunelveli Seemai. The name Tirunelveli is derived from the Tamil words Tiru meaning holy, Nel meaning paddy, and Veli meaning fence, referring to a legend that Lord Shiva protected a devotee's rice crop here. The district is located in the fertile basin of the Tamiraparani River. Adi Varaha Temple, dedicated to the Varaha avatar of Lord Vishnu, is located in Kalladai Kuruchi town in Tirunelveli district. The temple is believed to be more than 850 years old. This place is also known as Varaha Kshetram. As per legend, there was a king here who was a devotee of Lord Krishna. He once performed the Ashwamedha Yajna, where all the gods appeared to accept the offerings except Vishnu. All the seers who helped the king to perform the yajna then prayed to Vishnu, who appeared in the form of Varaha along with Lakshmi. Later, Kubera was traveling in the region and installed the Varaha idol at this site. In due course, the temple disappeared. After many years, a devotee got a dream and accordingly discovered the idols. The current temple was built with those idols. Later on, various kings, including the Nayak rulers, are believed to have contributed to the improvements to this ancient temple. Muthuswami Dikshitar composed the kriti Sri Lakshmi Varaham in praise of the Lord in the shrine. The location of the shrine is mentioned in the charanam as Tamraparni Tira. The kriti is in the ragam Abhogi and in the second vibhakti.
Shri Lakshmi Varaham Bhaje Dham Shri Lakshmi Varaham Bhaje Dham Shri Lakshmi Sahitam Shudra Janadi Shubha Pradam Janadi Shubha Pradam Shri Lakshmi Varaham Bhaje Dham Shri Lakshmi Sahitam Shuddha Janadi Shubha Pradam Shri Lakshmi Varaham Bhaje Dham
The famous Nellaiyappar temple in Tirunelveli is dedicated to Lord Shiva. Shiva is worshipped as Nellaiyappar or Venuvananathar, represented by the Lingam, and his consort Parvati is depicted as Kantimati Amman. The deity in the current temple was believed to have appeared inside the bamboo forest or Venuvanam. The temple is located on the northern banks of Tamarapurni River. The presiding deity is revered in the 7th century Tamil Shaiva canonical work, the Thevarum, written by Tamil saint poets known as the Nayanmars, and classified as a Padal Petrasthalam. The original complex is believed to have been built by the Pandya rulers, while the present masonry structure was added by Choras, Pallavas, Cheras, and Madurai Nayaks. The Kriti Shalivatishwaram in Devagandhari Ragam was composed by Dikshitar in praise of Lord Nellaiyappar residing in this shrine. Shalivatishwaram means the lord of the enclosure for rice grains, and his abode is mentioned as Shalivati Nagara, which is Tirunelveli. The Kriti is in the second Vibhakti.
शालिवाटीश्वरं भजे हम
Amor.
ಸೋರಂ ಸೋರಮೋನಿ ವಾರಂ ಬಾಲಿ ಪೂಜಿತ ಗ್ರೀಷ್ಮ ಮಹೋತ್ಸವ ಬಾಲಿ ಪೂಜಿತ ಗ್ರೀಷ್ಮ ಮಹೋತ್ಸವ ವೇದೇಂದ್ರಾದಿ ಗುರು ಮುಖನುತ ವೈಭವ ಬಾಲಿ ಪೂಜಿತ ಗ್ರೀಷ್ಮ ಮಹೋತ್ಸವ ವೇದೇಂದ್ರಾದಿ ಗುರು ಮುಖನುತ ವೈಭವ ತರಿ ಕಿಟ ತಕದಿ ತೇರಿ ಸರಿ ಮಗರೆ ತಕದಿ ಮಿತ ಕಪದ ರಿಸನಿದ ತಕಜಂ ತರಿ ಸರಿ ಗಮರಿ ತದ್ದರ್ ಗಿಡದ ಅಂದರ್ ಗಿಡದ ರಿಸರಿ ಮಗರಿ ಸರಿ ಧೀ ತದಾಭಿಮಿದ
The consort of Nellaiyappar is Devi Kantimati. Originally, the Nellaiyappar and Kantimati temples were two independent structures with spaces in between. It was in 1647 that Thiru Vadamalaiyappa Pillaiyan, a great devotee of Shiva, linked the two temples by building the Chain Mandapam or Sangili Mandapam as it is called in Tamil. The Kriti Shri Kantimatim in Ragam Hemavati is in praise of the Devi. Her abode is mentioned as Shuddha Tamraparni Tathasthitam, or the one dwelling on the banks of the pure river Tamraparni. The Kriti is in the second Vibhakti.
Shri Kanti Mahati
Na
Arulmigu Shankara Narayana Swami Temple is dedicated to Lord Shankara Narayana, who is an amalgamation of both Shiva and Vishnu. According to folklore, the devotees of Vishnu and Shiva once quarreled with each other to determine which god was more powerful, until Shiva appeared as Shankara Narayana to show his devotees that Hari and Hara were one and the same. The deities of the temple are Sri Shankareshwarar, Gomati Amman and Sri Shankara Narayanar. The temple is said to have been built by Ukkira Pandya in the 11th century when he stumbled upon an anthill and a Shivalingam by its side on his way to Madurai. Structures were later added to the temple by subsequent rulers. Devotees believe that the soil of the anthill or the puttaman found here has curative properties. It is given as prasad, which devotees consume with water. The kriti Shankara Narayanam Bhajeham in Ragam Narayana Desakshi is in praise of Shankara Narayana enshrined in this temple. The kriti is in the second vibhakti.
Shankara Narayanam Bhajeham, Shankara Narayanam. Shankara Narayani Priyakaram. వ్యాసగిరి విహారం శంకరం కపాల శూల మాలాదిధరం కాలహరం త్రిపురహరం కలి కల్మషాపహం కామిద ఫలదకరం శంకర నారాయణం వదేహం కైలాసగిరి విహారం శంకరం కపాల శూల కామిదఫలదకరం శంకర నారాయణం భజేహం సదాశివం నారాయణ దే సాక్షిరాగనుతం శంకర నారాయణం భజేహం
Rameshwaram is a town in the district of Ramanathapuram in Tamil Nadu and known as the Varanasi of the South. It is on Pamban Island, separated from mainland India by the Pamban Channel and is about 40 kilometers from Mannar Island in Sri Lanka. Pamban Island, also known as Rameshwaram Island, is connected to mainland India by the Pamban Bridge, a cantilever bridge. One of the four pilgrimage places or Char Dham of India, Rameshwaram invites followers of Lord Shiva from everywhere to visit at least once in their lifetime the Jyotirlinga installed in the Ramanatha Swami temple. Vaishnavites also consider this shrine as sacred because of its association with Lord Rama and incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Rameshwaram is believed to be the place from where Lord Rama started his journey to get Devi Sita back from Ravana, and the Lord was helped by the Vanara Sena army of legendary monkey humans and served by Hanuman, Lord Rama's paramount devotee. Also, many later versions of the Ramayana testify to the installing of a Shivalingam by Sri Rama and Devi Sita to worship Lord Shiva as a part of their penance for Brahmahatya, killing of Ravana, a Brahmin, who was himself a well-known devotee of Lord Shiva. Ramanatha Swami literally means Master of Rama, which in this case is Lord Shiva, who is worshipped as the principal deity in the Ramanatha Swami temple in Rameshwaram. As per mythology, on returning from Lanka, Rama asked Hanuman to get a lingam from the Himalayas. It is said that since Hanuman was getting delayed in returning with the lingam, Sita made one out of the sand on the seashore and that was worshipped. Both the lingams have been installed and are worshipped in the temple. The one brought by Hanuman is known as Vishwalingam and the other one made by Sita is known as Ramalingam. It is on the instructions of Rama that even today, the Vishwalingam is worshipped before the Ramalingam since it was brought by Hanuman. The temple has some of the longest corridors in the world and was renovated by the kings of the Pandya dynasty in the 12th century. The present structure was the work of many individuals spread over a number of centuries. The pride of place in the establishment of the temple goes to the Setupatis of Ramanathapuram. In the 17th century, Dalavai Setupati built a portion of the main eastern Gopuram. In the late 18th century, the world-famous third corridor was constructed by Muthuramalinga Setupati, who lived for 49 years and ruled between 1763 and 1795. The corridor was called Chokkattan Mandapam. Temple tanks or tirthams numbering 22, a hall of 1,000 pillars and several other shrines in the temple attract millions of pilgrims every year, especially during Mahashivaratri. The Kriti Ramanatham Bhajeham in Kashi Ramakriya Ragam is in praise of Lord Shiva enshrined as a Jyotirlingam in the Ramanatha Swami temple. The song is composed in the second Vibhakti. The Koti Tirtha tank located in the temple finds mention in the song as having been blessed with divine cleansing powers by the Lord.
Ramanatham bhajeham
The southernmost tip of Rameshwaram is known as Dhanushkodi. The Kodanda Ramaswamy temple is located here. This is the location where Vibhishana surrendered to Rama and was coronated as the de facto ruler of Lanka before the battle with Ravana. It is interesting to note that cyclones have battered and destroyed much of Dhanushkodi, but the temple has not been damaged by natural elements. Estimated to be about 500 to 1000 years old, the temple houses Rama as the main deity, holding the bow Kodanda in his hands, and hence the name Kodanda Ramaswamy for the deity. Composed in the ragam Kokilaravam and in the second vibhakti, the kriti Kodandaramam pays homage to Lord Rama enshrined in this temple. In the kriti, there is mention of how the sacred dust of Rama's feet relieved the pious Ahalya of her curse.
कौशल्यं विश्वामित्र इदमकौ